Amid a sunny forecast for the U.S. economy, the Federal Reserve Board raised lending rates by a quarter point. The Fed last raised rates a year ago, and that was the first rate hike since before the start of the Great Recession a decade ago. Economic damage wrought by the Great Recession has made this 90-month economic expansion different from other expansions. Unconventional monetary policy tools, like quantitative easing, have been used by the Fed to stimulate the economy. It's worked. Just released reports show the economy is growing. In fact, the growth figures are a pleasant surprise to many. Economists have recently been surprised, pleasantly, by the growth achieved without igniting inflation. The Fed's December 2016 inflation forecast did not change much from 3 months earlier, despite President-elect Donald Trump's plan to rebuild U.S. infrastructure. It did nudge up its 2019 inflation forecast by a tenth of 1% to 2.1%. The inflation policy of the Fed is pegged against the Personal Consumption Expense Deflator Index, which is different from the inflation rate in the headlines all the time. The headline inflation index, the one cited in the press, is the consumer price index. Looking at its performance, you can see that when gasoline prices tanked in mid-2008, the CPI plunged. But inflation made a full recovery and is now at a more normal level. The core inflation rate index excludes food and energy expenses, and it is now higher than the Fed's 2% target. But overall inflation remains almost completely dormant, despite some sparks of increasing growth. The increase of retail sales is one of those sparks. In the 12 months through the end of November, retail sales grew by 3.8%, compared with the 3.1% peak growth rate during the economic expansion of 2007. Retail sales are growing at a faster pace of almost 20%. The red bars represent expected growth rates based on the latest monthly survey of about 70 economists by the Wall Street Journal. The consensus forecast inched up 0.1% to a 2.4% expected growth rate over the four quarters of 2018. While not dramatic, an upward revision in the consensus forecast for growth is a move in the right direction. As important as the statistics are, perhaps the big economic news is that President-elect Donald Trump may be rethinking his relationship with Fed Chair Janet Yellen. Though candidate Trump accused Ms. Yellen of keeping interest rates low for political reasons in September, the President-elect leveled no such criticism after Ms. Yellen's 50-minute December press conference, even though she reiterated the Fed's tightening of rates over the longer term is expected to be gradual. Politics has made strange bedfellows of Mr. Trump and Ms. Yellen, who now share a common goal, growing the economy. All the good news about the U.S. economy has been welcomed by investors. America's largest public companies hit an all-time record high price again last week, and the Standard & Poor's 500 index was trading at about 19 times its earnings per share over the last 12 months. Stocks are fully valued. A 10 or 15% drop in stock prices could occur any time. When bad news hits, which historically has happened every year or two, some investors become fearful and cash out. Key economic benchmarks are showing none of the signs that normally precede a recession. And post-war America has experienced economic expansions lasting longer than the 90-month-long expansion still underway. This expansion would have to continue for 2.5 years to break the 120-month record growth streak from February 1991 to February 2001. With mass media being supplanted by sources of news not compromised by ad sales, and amid growing concerns over fake news, please rely on us as a trusted source of financial news and analysis based on data from authoritative sources and economic fundamentals. The Internet has made it possible to offer you an independent financial news channel not influenced by big media, Wall Street, or politics, and a prudent analysis of news affecting your wealth over the long run. Please feel free to share our timely weekly reports with your family and friends.